ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، welcome to another segment of Fathers and Sons in the Quran. Alhamdulillah, we have covered the story of Luqman and his son in our previous weeks. And today, inshallah, we will be embarking on another segment or another portion of the Quran. And this is a dialogue that takes place between Ibrahim alayhi salam and his beloved father. Now, subhanAllah, one thing that before I begin, I do want to mention that this story is mentioned in Surah Maryam. Surah Maryam is a very beautiful surah. And from beginning to end, if there is one word that you can use to summarize the entire surah, or if there is one main theme of the entire surah, it talks about the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It talks about the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. You talk about Zakariya alayhi salam, and how Allah had mercy upon him and gave him a son. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the story of Maryam alayhi salam and how Allah had mercy upon her and gave her a son. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also in this surah, he talks about, for example, a very beautiful ayah. He says, قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الضَّلَالَةِ فَلْيَمْدُدْ لَهُ الرَّحْمَنُ مَدَّ. That whenever a person goes astray, when a person goes away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has mercy upon him by giving him chance after chance after chance to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in the midst of all this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and regarding his context, and the fact that is mentioned in Surah Maryam, one of the key things that we learn is that when it comes to giving an advice, when a son is giving an advice to his own parents, a son needs to have the utmost amount of compassion and mercy towards his parents. See, one thing that we learn is that many times parents, as they age, is not necessarily always true that the more you age, the more you're going to always be right. SubhanAllah, we find that knowledge and understanding is not necessarily something that comes with age. In fact, so many times we find that our parents, after they have aged, they're still doing things that are completely wrong, that is considered Islamically wrong, morally wrong at times too. Sometimes they're preaching things in the family that you know very well that it's not right at all. So what do you do in that kind of situation? How many times I've had youth who have come to me and they have told me that they see their parents doing something that is wrong, and how do you give that advice to your parents without being disrespectful? Because a lot of times when it comes to giving an advice, even when the children do give an advice, sometimes they don't know how to give the advice, sometimes they do give the proper advice, but the parents, they sort of retaliate, or they would become very abrupt, or they would start making dua against their children, they would start saying things, you know, at their children, such as "we disown you" and so forth. So how do you deal with a situation when you know that the parents are doing something that is absolutely wrong? How are you supposed to address them, and what way are you supposed to correct the situation, and to what extent? This is something very important. To what extent do you correct this? And this is why we find this beautiful story in the Quran. So first of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says about Ibrahim alayhi salam, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet alayhi salam that mention the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam to the people, إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. He was a man of truth and he was a prophet. Now this word Siddiq is hard to just translate as he was a man of truth, and we truly understand the magnum of this word, or how amazing this word is. Remember that we find in the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was given this laqab or this title as Siddiq. Even till today, we refer to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu in this way. So what does that mean? Siddiq means that a person who has no shred of doubt, and a person who does not require any kind of proof to believe in Allah or to believe in a prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So in the case of the Prophet alayhi salam, when he went to Isra and Mi'raj, you know, there were people at that time who were Muslims. And the Qurayshi people came to them and they said that if perhaps, let's just say a man who says he went from here overnight, he went from here to Masjid Al-Aqsa, from there he went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, would you believe in him? And you know, people, they said that perhaps we would not believe in that kind of person. Or if we heard someone saying this, we would have some doubts. And then the Quraysh would say to some of these Muslims, this prophet of yours that you believe in, he's the one who's saying it. And then sometimes, you know, it's mentioned that they would say, oh, you know, subhanAllah, it's very interesting that he would say something like that. But at the same time, you have a person like Abu Bakr, radiallahu ta'ala, and he says that if the Prophet said it, if anyone were to say it, I don't believe them. But if the Prophet says, I don't need any proof, it is the absolute truth. It was after this that he was given this laqab as Siddiq, because there's no shred of doubt in Allah, there's no shred of doubt in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his validity. Even we find regarding Maryam alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ما المسيح ابن مريم إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل وأمه صديقة. That Allah is referring to the mother of Isa alayhi salam and saying she was a siddiqa. How was she a siddiqa? That first of all, when Jibreel alayhi salam came to inform her that she will have a child, and she says that how can I have a child when I have never been around a man? And he, Jibreel alayhi salam said that this is the through the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Now at that time, she never doubted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even after she had the child, when she brought the child back to her city and to her community, and people began to say, oh Maryam, where did this child come from? And they began to start having theories that perhaps she may have done something wrong and she may have committed evil, and this child is a result of that sin. Then what did she do? Without any hesitation, she had no doubt in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, she pointed at the child. فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّبُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ صَبِيًّا قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. SubhanAllah, look at the iman of Maryam alayhi salam. No shred of doubt. She just simply pointed at the child and they said, how can this child speak? Are you looking for validity? You're looking for this child to exonerate you and to prove that you are innocent? And then the Quran says, قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. This child began to speak up and he began to tell these people that I am the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is who I am. This is my mother, and she is free from any fault and from any sin. So this is why Maryam alayhi salam is referred to as a siddiq or a siddiqah. Likewise, in the case of Ibrahim alayhi salam, never did he ever question the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never did he ever have doubts. You know, one is that a person keeps on doing what they're being told to do, but there's always some doubt, you know, growing in their mind. This never happened with Ibrahim alayhi salam. Even when he went to Allah and he said that, how do you revive the dead? How do you bring life, or how do you pump life into something that is dead? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَوَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ. Do you not believe in me? Do you have doubts in your iman, O Ibrahim? And he says alayhi salam, no, I have no doubt. قَالَ بَلَا وَلَكِنْ لِيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي. So because of this conviction of faith, these are few individuals that we find in the Quran and in the sunnah of the Prophet sallam that they were called and they were given this title as Siddiq. So now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. Something else that we learn also from this story is that if giving an advice, because a lot of times when we see our parents doing something that is wrong, many times we hold back. And we hold back, why? Because if I say something to them, then this is going to hurt their feelings. This is, you know, they're not going to take it the right way. And so a lot of times children, they take a step back from even correcting their own parents. Once again, it has to be done the respectful way, and we'll talk more about this. But they usually hold back. And a lot of times, even if they go to their parents might try to even justify their actions, as we will see also in the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam and his father. So if this is ever a situation, remember that if giving an advice to our parents when they're doing something that is wrong, even bringing it up even once, if this was considered as a disrespect, if this is something that is considered as wrong, Allah would have never ever mentioned this story in the Quran. There is a reason why Allah mentioned this story in the Quran. Allah would not put a story in the Quran without having any purpose to it. So that's why this is a very powerful lesson for all of us, that if we see something being done wrong, yes, we have to correct it. When it comes to our parents, there is a certain way of doing it, and inshallah, we will go through this. We also find that when Ibrahim alayhi salam began to advise his father, the very first thing that he says in Surah Maryam after this first ayah, he says, Ya Abati, Ya Abati. And this is a beautiful way of Ibrahim alayhi salam calling out to his father. Now, you know, this all comes down to culture and how we sometimes refer to our fathers, but we have to refer to our fathers in a very respectful way. It doesn't have to be necessarily as Ya Abati. In that time, in the culture of Ibrahim alayhi salam, to say Ya Abati was probably the perhaps the best way or the most compassionate way to address his father. In this day and age, based on our culture, you can say anything you want. My dear father, my loving father, you know, and you know, whether you speak any other language, there are certain ways that you can say, you can express your my loving father. So this is something that you have to do when it comes to when it comes to talking to our parents. So the very first thing is Ya Abati Inni qad ja'a. He says, Ya Abati lima ta'budu ma la yasma'u wa la yubsiru wa la yughni 'anka shay'a. So instead of first of all coming down straight to this point of, oh my father, you are doing something that is absolutely wrong. He says, لِمَ تَعْبُدُ. My father, why would you want to do something like this? Instead of just trying to address the problem, he's trying to address this issue from a logical point of view. And that's absolutely fine. A lot of times when it comes to our seniors, when it comes to our elders, yes, at times I understand that using logic may not be of any avail. It may not work, but a lot of times this may be the right way to go about this. In this case, Ibrahim alayhi salam realizes that addressing my father in a logical way and bring up this argument in a logical way, this might be the best way. And he says, لِمَ تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعُ وَلَا يُبْصِرُ وَلَا يُغْنِي عَنْكَ شَيْئًا. What we want to find in a Rabb, when I worship someone, I know that I'm worshiping someone who is able to listen to my call, who's able to listen to my du'as, who's able to listen to my pain and my anguish and my challenges that I'm going through. If I'm calling out to someone or calling onto something or someone and they cannot comprehend, they cannot listen, they cannot see, then how is that going to help me? So here Ibrahim alayhi salam, from a very logical point of view, he's trying to address this by saying that, my father, you understand this logic. Why would you do something like this? You want to worship someone who's able to listen to you. How can you worship something that is not able to listen? Neither are they able to see. So from a logical point of view, he begins to address his father. And you know, subhanAllah, a lot of times people feel like that there is absolutely no way you can address people logically. You have to just use Quran and Sunnah, Quran and Sunnah. And that's not necessarily true. In this story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, he's addressing this matter from a logical point of view first. Then later on, he's going to bring in knowledge and the aspect of the Quran or the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it's absolutely fine. A lot of times we come across people and you can read Quran after Quran and Sunnah after Sunnah and nothing will change their heart. Sometimes in order to get a point across to someone, you have to come and resort to logical explanations or logical examples in order to help them understand. And that's absolutely fine. So here also we find Ibrahim alayhi salam, he did exactly that. Then after that, he says, Ya Abati inni qad ja'ani min al-ilm. So now what he's basically saying is that he's distinguishing here that one is my examples that I'm giving you. One is my knowledge. One is conventional knowledge versus revealed knowledge. Mine is conventional knowledge. This knowledge that has come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran, the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you can then, that is when he begins to use that, and he says to his father, Inni qad ja'ani min al-ilm, that Allah has revealed to me min al-ilm ma lam ya'tika, and this knowledge has not come to you, you're not aware of this. Fattabi'ni ahdika siratan sawiyya. He's basically telling his father that follow me, follow my teachings, whatever I'm telling you, whatever I'm advising you, do exactly that, and I will guide you onto the right path. And sawiyya means a path that will take you to your destination. Siratan sawiyya. This is why we say ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. So here, once again, Ibrahim alayhi salam is using now the revealed knowledge to get a point across to his father. So once again, when it comes to, let's just say, if there's a situation that we see our parents doing something that is wrong, In that case, you can advise your parents. First of all, you have to be at the highest level, you have to show respect to them. Disrespect is not tolerable in our deen, especially when it comes to our parents. Also, we learn that in the previous story of Luqman and his son, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach us there? He says, فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. That if the parents are telling you to do something that is wrong, the Quran did not say, Allah did not say that you antagonize them or use the knowledge against them. Because at times what happens is that you feel like you have so much knowledge that now I can go and I can just, you know, put down ayah after ayah against my parents, sunnah after sunnah against my parents because I know more than them. That is not also the objective here. Remember that. When it comes to even you're trying to rectify a situation, you see your parents doing something and you're trying to fix a situation, first of all is that you should not just go after them and repeat, you know, ayah after ayah, Quran after Quran, and sunnah after sunnah. That's not the best way. The Quran also tells us, فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا, simply do not obey them if they tell you to do something that is wrong. وَصَاحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا, but in this dunya, you behave with them in an upright manner. So this is what the Quran has taught us. We find this even from the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. We don't find so many occasions where Ibrahim alayhi salam would always come to his father and always try to give this advice to him over and over again. Sometimes the only thing you can do is, especially when it comes to, you know, children or teenagers, you may have troubling parents, you may have parents who don't understand well, they're not trying to understand your point, and they are, you know, they're saying things against you. They may, you know, they're saying things such as, you are a very disobedient child, we disown you, and they say these kind of like negative things. In that case, you can first talk to your parents and try to explain to them. Sometimes use logic if you need to. If they don't understand logically, you can use the Quran and use the Sunnah, but not in a way that you're trying to really, you know, you're trying to make a point to them. You understand what I'm trying to say? Is that you can make a point in a respectful way, and there's a wrong way of trying to make a point. So that's why the Quran is teaching us that you can make a point using the Quran and using the Sunnah, but at the same time, it has to be in a way that you're showing love. Once again, the story is mentioned in Surah Maryam, and the Surah is about Rahmah and mercy. So we have to show that mercy and that love to our parents. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He talks about further on, what did Ibrahim alayhi salam say to his father? He says, Ya abati, lima ta'budu shaytan. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لِلرَّحْمَنِ عَصِيًّا. Oh my father, this is the footstep of shaitan. This is the path of shaitan. And shaitan is someone who is disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he wants to see other people disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So once again, if we find ourselves in this kind of situation, then we logically explain to our parents, very humbly, very nice. Disrespect, once again, is not going to be tolerated here. And you don't have to do it over and over again. You simply are good with them. You explain it one time. Now, in this case, Ibrahim alayhi salam came. He explained to his father. And then he's explaining to him that how this is not the right way to do things. Now we find that Ibrahim alayhi salam's father is responding to him now. And he says that inni, in fact, Ibrahim alayhi salam says, inni akhafu an yamassaka adhabu min ar-rahman fatakuna lish-shaytani waliya, that I fear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send his ghadab upon you, he will send his wrath upon you because of these things that you are doing, and the fact that you are worshipping some other entity besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, after giving and trying to explain his father in so many different ways, in a very loving way, ya abati, my dear father, my beloved father, I love you so much, I care for you so much, this is not the right thing to do, he lashed out at Ibrahim alayhi salam. He says, أَرَاغِبٌ أَنْتَ عَنْ آلِهَتِي يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ, are you trying to deter me away? Are you trying to take me away from these idols? This is my bread and my butter. This is what I believe in. And this is what I put my, you know, I put my belief in this. And then he says, لَإِن لَمْ تَنْتَهِ لَأَرْجُمَنَّكَ وَهْجُرْنِي مَلِيَّ, that if you do not stop this, I will stone you. This is Ibrahim alayhi salam's father resorting to, in some way, a type of violence, that I will stone you, so get away from me, otherwise I will punish you. So here we find that Ibrahim alayhi salam's father is sort of now responding to him, and he's not thinking rationally, he's thinking that this is my son, I know better than him, he has no idea what he's talking about, and he's trying to tell me what to do. And this can happen a lot of times with parents also. They would feel that no matter how much you explain to them, how much loving you are towards them, because I've seen situations too, that, you know, youth or, you know, men are trying to explain to their dear fathers, their senior fathers, that what they're doing is wrong, and they are, you know, they are exhibiting akhlaq, they are exhibiting compassion and mercy, and they're trying to explain, but then after a while, they lose their temper. And once again, Ibrahim alayhi salam, never, ever once in this entire conversation did he ever lose his temper. And that's a very powerful lesson for all of us. That it doesn't mean that in the beginning you can be compassionate and then you lose your cool. It doesn't work like that. So that's why we find that Ibrahim alayhi salam, when his father said, I will stone you, I will punish you, and this can happen, then Ibrahim alayhi salam, he simply took a step back, and he never again brought up this matter to his father. He did what he had to do, and he did it only once, and then he says, Salamun alayka, sa'astaghfiru laka rabbi, innahu kana bi hafiyya. He says, Salamun alayk, may peace be upon you. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgives you and He gives you the understanding. And what salamun here means, even we find in the Quran, when someone who is ignorant, they come across you and they misbehave with you, the best thing to do is, qalu salama. You simply walk away, you keep your respect intact, do not come down to their level, and do not say the same thing what they have said to you. Just simply be at peace and walk away. So here also, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he knows that his father is not acting in a rational way. He knows that his father is absolutely wrong, but he does not lose his temper. He simply says, Salamun alayka, sa'astaghfiru laka rabbi. I will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. I will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance. And then he says, Innahu kana bi hafiyya. Verily, he is unto me ever most gracious. That when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is always very gracious to me. And when I ask Allah, hopefully Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will accept my du'as. Now, as a result, what did He say? وَأَعْتَزِلُكُمْ. He tells his father that I have nothing to do with what you are doing. And subhanAllah, you know, many times you hear stories like this too, that, you know, children see their parents doing something that is wrong, and their parents are telling them, we want you to do the wrong with us. We want you to follow us. And at that time, if the child simply says, or the son or the daughter says, I cannot engage with the wrong that you are doing, that's absolutely fine. Do not be disrespectful, but you can simply decline in a very respectful way and turn away from that. Do not be rude or disrespectful. And so here Ibrahim says, alayhi salam, وَأَعْتَزِلُكُمْ. I am going to leave, and I should turn away from that which you are worshipping. And then he says, "Asa Allah akuna bidu'a'i Rabbi shaqiyya," that I shall call upon my Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord, and I hope that I shall not be unblessed in my invocation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then as a result, subhanAllah, think about this, how sincere Ibrahim alayhi salam was in his approach, how respectful he was in his approach. He loves to see his father to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants to see his father to accept what he is saying, but his father did not. But as a result, that pain that he had by seeing his father falling into this kind of dalala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave Ibrahim alayhi salam two other children. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the next ayah, فَلَمَّا اعْتَزَلَهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ وَكُلًّا جَعَلْنَا نَبِيًّا. Subhanallah. Whenever you are in pain, whenever we are in this kind of situation, remember that if you are truly sincere, Allah will take that pain away. Allah will replace that pain with some other happiness. And here in the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, we find, and Allah says, we gave him Ishaqa wa Yaquba. We gave him a son and we gave him a grandson. And we all know that Ibrahim alayhi salam had two children, Ismail and Ishaq, and Ishaq had Yaqub, and Yaqub had Yusuf, and the story goes on. But as a result, Ibrahim alayhi salam's respect and how much he did for his father and how he was considerate of his father's feelings, we learn that Allah subhanahu gave him these children as a way to console Ibrahim alayhi salam and to replace the pain that he was going through of the fact that his father did not convert to Islam. So once again, if we ever find ourselves in a situation where our parents are doing something that is wrong, our Quran teaches us, the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam teaches us, that how should we deal in that kind of situation? How should we deal with the situation? How should we treat our parents? And how should we converse with our parents? How to sometimes either the Quran and Sunnah, or sometimes logically trying to get a point across to them, is absolutely fine. But at the same time, I will reiterate, Respect is very important. And if your parents are not willing to understand, do not antagonize them. Do not be rude or disrespectful. Do not say that, you know, may Allah, you know, do not pray against them, but always pray for them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that these stories of the Quran between fathers and sons in the Quran, may Allah give us ability to learn from them and apply these beautiful teachings in our life. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما إن الذين يؤذون الله ورسوله لعنهم الله في الدنيا والآخرة وأعد لهم عذابا مهينا والذين يؤذون المؤمنين والمؤمنات بغير ما اكتسبوا فقد احتملوا بهتانا وإثما مبينا.